I'm going to be talking about this stuff in a way that hopefully will be engaging, but does not make light of the topic. Okay, this is a serious topic. I'm not making fun of it, but I'm hoping to catch your attention for a little bit. So if you'll stick with me, I think we can make this a fun hour. Okay? So my first question to you is, are you ready?
Yes.
How about, okay, no, really, are you ready? I appreciate up front here the dancing. That was great. Keep that up. So today, or tonight, I'm going to be telling you a story. Really, it's a story of your next kind of 24 hours. I'm going to be telling you a story, and to do it, I'm going to be using some songs. We're going to go through a series of songs. And what that means is if you recognize the song, if you love that song, if you're like, yeah, that's my jam, then please, please sing along, dance along, clap, jump up, front row, I'm looking at you. Okay? You got a lot of space up here to dance along. So, and now here we are on your first Saturday night, your first Saturday at college, and I know what some of y'all are thinking. I know you're thinking this. What is up with the old lady? Like, why is there an old lady at this pool party? And remember that alcohol is only part of the picture here. Really, I'm not here to talk about alcohol, although alcohol is a part of what I'm going to talk about. It's only part of the picture. And in all reality, we're here to talk about this. I didn't think some of y'all would know that song. It's pretty old. So in reality, we're here to talk about a little thing called Title IX. So what is Title IX? I want you to go with me for a second. There's really very few engaging ways that I can present a policy to you, but I want you to go with me for just a couple seconds here. Does that sound like something I think we can all get behind? Can you get behind that? Okay. And more specifically, this policy covers these things. Sexual assault, sexual misconduct, sexual harassment, intimate partner violence, stalking, and retaliation. All of this comes from a federal law called Title IX, which most of you probably are thinking about in terms of athletics, but applies to sexual misconduct as well. So we got to talk about some more dynamics here. Most of the time we think about this being a male-on-female sort of situation, but you need to know that that's not every time. We also could have a female on a transgendered person or someone who does not identify as any gender. You could have someone on the transgender spectrum on someone else. You could have a female on a male. You could have a male victimizing a person who is transgendered. And quite frankly, you could have any combination thereof. It does not have to be one-on-one. It could be multiples. And so once you start to build this out, you see that really, it's everybody. Anybody could be victimizing another. What you're hearing there is my son. He's 2, and he just had to come out. So, yes, thank you. So really what we're talking about here is people on people, regardless of gender expression, regardless of sex. We're talking about people victimizing people. Or maybe this is you when you get to the party. Okay, does anybody actually do this thing at a party? Like, is that a thing? What is that? If you go to a party and they're doing this thing, you're in trouble, okay? Just turn around. That's weird. So, you know, when I'm dealing with the difficult things in life, when I'm really bogged down by a tough subject like this, I like to go back to some poetry to really see what some of the great thinkers have put pen to paper and come up with. And so, you know, I like to go, well, what would Maya Angelou say? Or what would Byron say about this sort of thing? And really, most importantly, what would Kanye say? What would Kanye say about this topic? Whoa! Whoa! That escalated very, very quickly. So here we were talking about you just showed up to a party. You just did the this thing, right? You just came in. And now we've gone straight to the scary place. We have ramped it up in our brains to where when we're talking about sexual assault, we must be talking about that guy in the bushes jumping out and grabbing me. That's where we go. And then our eyes do that thing, which is totally weird, right? It gets weirder the longer you look at it, doesn't it? And what we know from the research is that the scary stuff is not the typical. So 73% of perpetrators of sexual assault were not strangers, according to the U.S. Department of Justice. We know that in 73% of the cases, the perpetrator was known to the survivor or the victim. It's a known thing. It's not the scary stranger jumping out. It's a friend. It's a relationship. It's the person you just met. It's someone you know.